God bless you. You are listening to The Path at 1717 Via del Rio, Corona, California, 92882. And you can call us for prayer at 951-737-1717. And we are going to start, our verse for the day is going to be in Acts 20:35. And we read the Bible in the name of the Son, the Father, and the Holy Spirit. And it says, in everything I did, I showed you that by his kind of hard work, we must help the weak. Remembering the words of the Lord Jesus himself said, it is more blessed to give than to receive. Amen. And with that, we're going to start our prayer. Father God, I thank you, Father God, for another morning that you've allowed us to be here. I thank you, Father God, because we are here, Father God, we are ready to learn your word. We're here, Father God, with all the tribulations that we have, Father God, but we are here with a humbled heart. We are here ready to learn from you. We are here with a thankful heart. We are here, Father God, because it is your own duty for us to be here. I pray, Father God, that everyone that's here serving, that you give them the strength, that you give them, Father God, that love, that they continue to serve you, Father God. I also pray for this worship team, Father. I pray that it is you and them, Father God, giving us, Father, that praise that we need to hear, Father God. And that when they are praising, Father God, that it is you listening to them. That you hear every single instrument, every single voice, Father God. That it is you, Father God, in them, giving them those talents that come only from you, Father. Oh, Father, I also pray for our Pastor Jael, Father, that it is you, Father God, in her, giving her the words that we need today. That when we leave, Father God, where our hearts are filled, our mind is filled, Father. Oh, Father God, I thank you for everyone that's here. And I pray in your name, Father God, amen. And with that, we're going to give the worship team.
Bless everybody in this beautiful morning. How's everybody doing? Amen. Today we're going to be taking this time to worship. Thank you.
Amen. He's the only one who cares. I like that version, that part, because at the end of the day, no matter the situation or the things that we deal with, God is the only one who cares. He sees your pain. He sees your hurt. He sees that if you're confused, he sees your doubt. But he wants for you to be reminded this morning that he cares. Because he's the only one who cares. Because at the end of the day, if you are battling through something, let's be honest, sometimes you go to sleep crying, right? You and you by yourself, you're crying. You're sobbing. You have no words. You are in disbelief. But he says, I care for you. And I love you. Amen. So we're going to do our offering and our tithes this morning. In this beautiful morning, Sunday, that the Lord allows us to be here. Amen. Father God, I want to thank you for this time, for letting us be here, Jesus. Thank you, Father God, for this time that we're going to be doing the offering and the tithes. Continue blessing those, Father God, that are working, those that don't have job, Father. We ask and we pray that you just bless them, Father God, in any way. Thank you for letting us always have food, Father, in our table. In Jesus' name we pray and we say, amen. You may come forward. And on those that are watching our social media. Blessed. Amen. And talking about blessed, so today I titled the message, You Are More Blessed to Give Than to Receive. Amen. Word of God. Father God, I want to thank you for this time that you allow us to be here, Jesus. Thank you for this word that we're going to be bringing, Father. Like we always say, Father, it's not me, but you using me, Father, to bring this word, that every word, Father God, that comes out of my mouth, Lord, that we continue growing, Father, and knowing more, Father. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. So this earlier we read Acts 20:35. If you go open your Bibles to Acts 20:35, we already read it this morning, but we're going to read it again. And the word of God says, in the name of the Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit. And everything I did, I showed you that by this kind of hard work, we must help the weak, remembering the words of the Lord Jesus himself said, it's more blessed to give than to receive. It's more blessed to give than to receive. We see here that Paul's relationship with these believers is a beautiful example of Christian fellowship. He had cared for them and loved them, that he even cared for their needs. Paul even gives example, not just giving them physical things such as money or food, but time as caring, sharing, rejoicing, and crying with those that need it. That you're giving yourself time to them. Have you guys ever, heard stories, or someone's going through something and they're crying, they're in that pain, and you cry with them, right? And you say, man, I know that feeling, or I'm sorry you're going through that. Because even the Bible says that we need to weep with those that weep. We need to be happy with those that are joyful, those that are happy, right? And sometimes you just cry, you hear those things, and you feel the pain. Has that happened to anybody, or just me? No one? Oh my gosh, hopefully in the name of Jesus that you guys could have that feeling, because it's so beautiful, especially when we're doing unity, guys. It's like, I will be crying with these people because I know the pain. I know the hurt that they're going through. Maybe someone that has lost a loved one. I personally never been there yet. I still have my brothers. I still have my parents, like really close family member. And I don't know that deep sorrow, that deep pain that maybe someone has lost somebody, right? But he recommended Paul to them as an example of not caring as to things of the present world, that this they will find for their comfort passage through it. It might seem a hard saying, therefore Paul asked to this saying of their masters, which he had been to always remember, it is more blessed to give than to receive. It seems there were words often used to his disciples. The opinion of the children of this world is contrary to this. They are afraid of giving unless in hope of getting clear gain. It is with them the most blessed thing that can be. But Christ tells us what is more blessed, more excellent, and makes us more like God, who gives all and receives from none, and to the Lord Jesus, who went above about doing things. This mind was in Christ Jesus. May it be with us as well, and are good for friends when they part with prayer. Those who exhort any prayer for one another may have many weeping season and painful separation, but they will meet before the throne of God to be part to no one. It was a comfort to all the presence, for both went him and stayed with him. A lot of us, when we want to help somebody, we want it in return. Oh, I'm going to help you today. Oh, I'll be there for you today. Oh, you know, when I need a favor, I'm going to need that. I'm going to need that favor back. Why are you looking at your brother? Mm-hmm. Right? That's what happens. Hey, I'm going to do your favor, but in return, I need that. Jesus didn't say, I'm going to go to the cross and I need you to go to the cross after me. He said, I will die for your sins. And you are new. And I want to make something new in you. God, please, I need this favor, Lord. I need you to help me with this depression. I need you to help me with my children. I need you to help me with my marriage. And God says, I will do it. Oh, no, God, you know, if you don't answer this prayer, I'm not going to serve you. If you don't answer this prayer, I'm not going to go to church today. If you believe it or not, there's people that think that way. And God says, it's okay. I have another servant that will want to do it. I have another sister that will want to do it. I have another, daughter. I will have another son that will do it. And then we get so mad at God, right, that things don't go our way. Where is our heart? God didn't give you life just so you could be like, okay, God, you give me life. You're going to do favors for me, and that's it. God is not a genie. He's the most powerful God that's willing to do anything and change every circumstances in our life. That is God. Those words quoted by Paul as well known are not found in any other of the four Gospels, but nevertheless genuine. They only preserve a fragment to the saying and doing things for our Lord. John 21:25 says, Jesus did many other things as well. If every one of them were written down, I suppose that even the whole world would not have room for the books that it will be written. God has done so much for us, that we are still ungrateful. We still complain. We still fight. We still groan instead of saying, thank you, God, because I received what you did for me today. Thank you, God, because even though I got in a little car accident, it could have been worse. The other day I got in a car accident and I got my permit at 15 because I really wanted to drive really bad. And so I got my license at 16. I only had one ticket when I was 18 for speeding. Don't do that, okay? Because that's a big ticket. I was 18 at the time. And, you know, that ticket was $500 for speeding. I was going 80 miles per hour on the freeway, okay? It's still speeding. But anyways, and the other day I was in Urco. Oh, you guys don't know where I live now. I was, you know, on the street, and I was on my light, regular on my light. Okay, I'm going to do this. I was on my light, and then out of nowhere, some girl was right here, and during the accident happened because it was green light and one like that. She literally hit the passenger side. So my mom and the baby were in the back. And all we feel is like, oh my gosh, just pulled to the side. And she was like, I was trying to get your attention for me to go. And I was like, well, if I didn't see you, then you should have not gone because I didn't see you. And so she hit me really hard. And I got a little dent in my car. And she had a really nice Camaro. The whole bumper from the front came off. Those cars look nice and the bumper came off. I only got a Ford and I don't know how that happened. But anyways, so she crashed me and before I used to get mad for everything. Why this happened? Now I'm like, thank you, God, because my mom and my baby are safe. It could have been worse. It could have been worse. But see, sometimes, man, my car, now I have to spend money on it, now this, and then my tires. Thank you, God, because it could have been worse. See, a lot of people, when you think about your situation and you see other people that tell their stories, you're like, wow, what I'm going through is nothing compared to what she's going through or what he's going through. And this is why God tells us we need to be grateful for the things. We need to be really grateful because we are here today. And you guys are here listening to the word. And I'm here bringing the word. And I say, God, thank you. Because I couldn't have been here today. But you gave me life. I was sharing in the Spanish last Sunday. A family friend, her son was homeless. He was doing drugs. He was in the streets. And she would go take him his food. And so she lived, and he lived like maybe a few blocks down, but she would see her son. He was in drugs, and she didn't want him in the house. The next day, she went to take him food, and he was dead in the floor. 29 years old. But see, we're here. And even though if you have a drug problem or alcohol problem, anyone that's here, anyone's watching, let me tell you that this is a chance for you to make it right. This is a chance for you to change the ways. Maybe it's not a drug problem. Maybe it's a sexual problem. Maybe it's a, you know, you like women or you like men. Today is a day to make the change. Today is a day to say, God, you know what? Make something new in me. Giving, even here, secures more real happiness than receiving. And besides, it's God-like and bless over. Giving obeys God's command. You know, the other day I even said it on the radio, and I won't mind sharing it again. Even though my life wasn't straight with God, those that know me for so many years, my walk, even though my parents are pastors, they're not taking me to heaven. If I don't have my relationship to God, and my parents will tell me, you keep doing that, you're going to go straight to hell. You know how my dad is, right? He's straight up, right? And so even though my life wasn't with God, something that I was always scared of is not giving my tithes. I would never steal God. Because my conscience is like, man, I can't do this to you, God. I would do my makeup. Mom, here's my tithes. I would do this. Here's my tithes. Even though if I don't come to church, I will still give my tithes. That's me saying, you know, God, I don't want to steal from you. This is my responsibility. And your word says I have to tithe. There's offerings. People, if it's in your heart to give, right? Because we can't force you, oh, here, you have to give. No, it's what God puts in your heart. When you do a favor for someone, it's what God puts in your heart. When you want to help someone out, it's what God puts in your heart, right? But giving obeys God's commandments. The Old Testament has many more commands about financial giving, who, when, and how much, than the New Testament. Maybe the New Testament writers just assume that God has given far more to us in the New Testament, giving himself to death, that our giving should follow fairly, logical, and easily. For you to give, you know when you give yourself to someone or you help someone, you do it with love, right? You don't be like, oh, you're going to help me, I'm going to need gas money for that. We don't do that, right? Hopefully not. Because we do it because God has blessed you with gas. Hey, why not be blessing for other people? You are blessed to be blessing for someone else. We are blessed to bless other people. You have food on your table. You have clothes, right? We need to be grateful. 1 Corinthians 1:2 says, to the church of God in Corinthians, to those who sanctified in Christ Jesus and called to be his holy people, together with all those everywhere who call on the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, their Lord and ours. As of all, God's commands are to give to enhance our lives. Obeying his commands will increase our happiness. Don't you guys have that joy when someone needs something and they get so excited? The other day we went to Denny's and I really didn't have change with me. You know, iPhones, technology, Apple Pay, you know, that's so easy, right? And so I remember I was leaving and some guy was just there. We were with my friends and some guy was just there. And he was like, man, I need some money. I'm hungry. And I'm like, honestly, I don't have anything. He's like, I'm just really hungry. I'm like, okay, well, let's go inside. Let's get you something to eat. And he was getting, he's like, I want pancakes and then and some bacon and some more bacon and the bacon. And then Jackie was like, you don't want anything to drink? And he was like, no, I'm good. We're like, yeah, get a soda, get something. He's like, okay, let me get a Coke. It was just so beautiful to see that. Even though he was like almost, what, 35, 40 years old, it was beautiful to me. And then I'm like, you sure you don't want something to go? Like, you maybe food for tomorrow? He's like, no, it's okay. I just really appreciate that. How many people have you helped and you saw that joy? How many? And if you can't use your fingers to count, I think it's time to help someone out today. Because that's what we are called, to be different. When you're in the grocery store, I don't know if it's happened to you guys, someone doesn't have that extra change, and then you're like, I'm not trying to give my money. I wanted this candy. Come on, be honest. You don't want to get, you're like, and then you start putting something down. But you see that that's a lot of money, so you put another thing down. Because there's people that go to the grocery stores, right? Right? And they don't have enough money. What do you do? Do you help? Oh, wow, the sky. The sky? You inside a building. How many of us help those? Maybe right there, God is testing your heart. Maybe right there, because that happened to me. One day I was at the gasoline station. I only had $20 with me. And some lady was collecting cans. Una viejita. And I'm like, I wanted to get coffee. Literally, that was in my mind. I wanted to get coffee. And I just saw the way she was putting the bottles in. It was biting the devil, you know. I was trying not to see her, but I was seeing her. And I'm like, here, God bless you. Dios te bendiga. Oh, no, it's okay. I'm not poor. I'm just collecting cans. And I'm like, I'm not saying you're poor, but, you know, go get something to eat. Go get something to eat. She's like, oh, okay, gracias. And I'm like, okay, God bless you. And, you know, me, you know, we have a radio station. Just listen to the radio. And so we left. And I was like, man, I really needed my coffee. I wanted my coffee. So anyways, so I go. And I come and I do what I have to do. And then I go in my purse because Yolanda, you know, she did her duties. And when I reach under my purse, I had change in there. I had money in there. Not knowing, I was thinking I had my only $20 in there. That's how God works. So I got me a coffee and I had enough to get more coffees after that. That's my God. That's who I serve. And sometimes, guys, that $5, I know you guys could help. I know you guys, it's in your heart to give, but that's what the enemy wants to do. The enemy wants to say, hey, don't give, or you don't have to do this, or don't help that person. No, we are different. We're loving. You are loving, right? You guys are loving, and to give and to help. And not to put anyone on blast, but I'm going to put someone on blast. The sister, la hermana, ¿cómo se llama? Jackie. Okay. So our sister, un día de, we were having the what is that? Not Misión Acción. We were having a big event. La Naciones, I think it was. And, you know, there was this mom that her son was detained by immigration. And at that time, you know, Unity, we weren't really doing a lot of shirts or anything. And so I was saying, hey, there was this mom, her son, and you were talking about her son. And then Mana came up to me and she gave me money and she was like, here, give it to the lady. And I just saw the tear in her eye and it was beautiful. And I told this lady, hey, look, remember, you're not alone. Here's some money for you. That's what God calls us to do, to give. To give. If your brother can't do it, your sister can't do it, you could do it. I could do it. Let's not ignore. Let's obey to God. Giving submits to God's lordship. Every act of obedience recognizes that there is a higher authority in our lives. Amen? Which is God. That there is a Lord over us who is entitled to honor, respect. Due to our temperament, personality, or circumstances, we may find some commands relatively easy to obey. Our submissions are really tested in the areas where our own nature and situation make obedience more difficult. For most of us, money is one of those areas. Oh yeah, I'm going to give. Or I'm going to help. Oh, we need $5. No, I don't got $5. Sometimes we want to apply what we want to apply, but we need to apply everything in the Bible. Not just some of it. Not just half of it. All of it. All of it we need to apply. And this is what the Bible says. Amen? Our submission is tested in areas where nature and situations make obedience more difficult. Our wallet is more often the last credential to fall to God's rule. And even when it does fall, it gets rebuilt and resecured again all too quickly. If only we could remember that divine lordship is not a threat rather than a great safely. Paul speaks to the efficient on giving. When Paul quotes this famous phrase in Acts 20:35, he's reminding the Ephesians church and elders of how God has worked in him to testify the gospel of grace of God, Acts 20:24. And we say, God is the one that supplies our needs. God, amen. Yes, he does. But what are we doing as a church? What are we doing in our part to give, to build? He has blessed, he didn't bless us just to accumulate so much money. He has blessed us for us to be blessings for other people. As Paul mentioned his last trip to Ephesians, Macedonia in Greece, he ought to collect an offering of needing Christians before delivering. To care for themselves. I'm not just talking about giving money. No. I'm not just talking about, hey, help someone else. No. I'm talking about, where is your time also? When that brother or that sister, I need prayer, man. Your situation, you're comfortable. You got your family. You got everything. You're comfortable. But where is that person that says, I need you. Please pray for me. Or when have we texted someone, say, hey, thinking about you. I'm praying for you. When was the last time you done it? Don't you guys feel just when someone texts you and says, hey, I'm praying for you, you're like, oh my gosh. Right? It's beautiful. Now we have to be that difference for someone else. Paul states that we work hard to keep the weak. Most likely referring to the poor. Oh, sorry, I read that. The New Testament calls for us to give both family of faith, okay, which is us, and outsiders. Galatians 6:10. Our worlds to the poor and weak, whether inside or outside of the church, are demands. Oh, I'm not going to give that person because, you know, he's homeless and he probably does drugs and he probably gets drunk. You don't know that. The Lord convicted me one day, very heavy. There was someone at 7-Eleven asking for money, and come on, straight up, you could tell when someone's a druggie or they're in drugs. I'm like, I'm not going to give him money. What, so he could go do the drugs? The Lord said, give. I was battling, okay? So I give this guy money. I'm like, here, God bless you. But I honestly gave it like, here, whatever. Like, you know, because I was like, no, he's going to use it for drugs. I sat in the parking lot at 7-Eleven right here. Tell me why the guy went inside, got food, and came out. And I said, God, forgive me. Because we start judging. I'm not going to give. They, you don't know. You know, there's people that say, oh, they have money for this, but no, there's people that have money just for their needs. But maybe they don't have extra money to say, hey, let me take all my kids out. Let me do this out for my kids. The Lord convicted me. And ever since that day, I don't ever judge a homeless anymore. I don't know their life. Most people are homeless, yes, because they, you know, did drugs or, you know, they did other things. But some people are homeless because California getting too expensive. Too expensive. Okay, even the gas. My friend came from Texas. She was like, $4? Because over there is like $2. And I'm like, $4, girl. Okay, with my car, I now fill it up with $80, $85. My car. And you guys know I do a lot of this. But I'm like, you know what, God? Thank you, because I got a car, right? But this is why we're not supposed to judge those. Because you don't know. Maybe they're really hungry. Maybe they want some food. When Jesus did his miracles, he didn't judge. He didn't. He did what he had to do. And we have to do the same, to not judge. No practical action is taken to help them. James 2:14 to 17. Therefore, when we consider that Jesus meant what he said, it's more blessed to give, or giving must not only be in spiritual and emotional state, but practically with finances and resources. God calls all people to steward their resources wisely to the sake of the gospel and to help the poor, the weak, the widow, and the orphan. So my question to you today in this service is, why? And I really want you to really meditate this, okay? Why is it so hard for us to give? Why is it so hard to give $5, to give $10, to even give your time? Why is it hard? When someone is in need, why is it hard to extend your hand? Why is it hard to say, oh, you don't have extra change when you're in the supermarket? Don't worry, I'll pay for it. Why is it so hard? We are so greedy. I'm gonna be honest, we're greedy. We don't want to share. We don't want to give. We want for me, I. We're not that important. I'm sorry. We're not that important. You have something so special in your heart that God wants to use what you have for his glory and only his glory. And I just want to remind you, I'm not just talking, please don't get me, I'm not just talking about the money wise. I'm talking about your time as well. It's more blessed to give. You're giving your time to the Lord. You're making a sacrifice for the Lord. God doesn't think twice about helping you. God doesn't think twice about giving you the desires of your heart. He does it because he loves you. So why is it so hard for us to do that? Well, yeah, I'm battling, you know, my finances, I'm battling. Okay, then, you know what? You don't want to give someone to a homeless? Why don't you make some sandwiches and take it to the homeless at home? Why don't we do something else? We use so much excuses, I don't have. Then where's your time? Like right now that we're going to be going to TJ to give the toys next week, right? And we're saying, hey, those that would like to donate a toy, if you can, you can. If you can't, amen. Are you giving your time and praying for us? Maybe a lot of you guys are like, man, the ticket, I can't go to Santo Domingo, I can't go to Colombia, I can't, it's too far. Okay, we're doing something local. You're not even putting gas. Okay? We need your time to go take these kids, to do this happy day, to do this event for the children, this missionary work. Where's your time? Oh, well, you know, I don't have papers or I can't go. Okay, it's okay. Well, where's your time? Let's make the baggies here. Let's make the candy bags here. Oh, I don't have to. And that's how we start going, and that's how we start going. If one area you can't, let's say because of your finances, there's another area you can. But the thing is, we don't want to. We don't. We don't take the time. We don't sacrifice the time. Or take that time to call someone you haven't seen at church, or you haven't seen, or you haven't heard, or just say, someone new, hey, you know, can I have your number? You know, I just want to talk with you and call you. How you doing? How you been? We need to give our time to those. Because maybe a word that you say to that brother or that sister, you don't know how it's going to impact them. You know, believe it or not, some conversations that I have with brothers and sisters, I'm like, I needed that, even though I'm a pastor. I have a sister that sends me messages. Hey, we're praying for you. How are you doing? I needed that. So we have to do the same. We are called to be what? Disciples. To go out there. To go out there and say, Jesus loves you. To go out there and say, let me pray for you. You guys know once a month, we have an activity. It fits with the Spanish church or with the English church. Remember, we're all the same church for Mission in Action that we're going to start in March. We're going to need help. We're going to need people that want to help. Give your time. That's what I'm asking. Just give your time for the Lord. Let this year be different. Let this year say, you know what, God? I'm going to take some time and I'm going to have some time with you. How many of us wake up in the morning and say, you know what, God? Let me have some time with you. Let me have 2 minutes, 5 minutes with it. Or how many of us sit in the car and say, you know what, God? All day I was so busy. I was at work all day. I had problems. And at that time that you're inside the car and say, you know what, God? I thank you. Where is that time? This is easy for us, a lot of us, including me. By the time you know it, it's already 2 hours have passed. 3 hours have passed. I'm not saying there's nothing wrong with it, with you being on your phone. What I'm saying is we don't sacrifice or take the time that needs to be given to God. That's all I'm saying. Now that we have services Tuesdays, Wednesdays, Thursdays, and Sundays, we're going to have at 8 a.m., 10 a.m., 2 p.m., and 6 p.m. 4 services. And those that say, Jóvenes, Pastora Valeria, Thursdays. English, my kid don't speak. Trust me, when I was the pastor for the Jóvenes, you guys remember? We don't speak Spanish. ¿Quién quiere $100? I thought you speak Spanish. I don't speak Spanish. Why are some of you guys laughing, huh? Right? I don't speak Spanish. Okay, now there's an English service. And it's English. I don't speak English or Spanish. I could do sign language. Do I keep going? I'm blind. Well, you hear. We're laughing, but I'm serious. Where is our time for the Lord? Sometimes I even catch myself. I'm like, sorry, God. Let me take some time for you. Let me take some time for you. Because when we want things, the first resource is God. God. And God said, where is my time? You know, God wants to speak to a lot of us, but we don't take that time to hear what God wants to do and what God wants to change in our life. With that battle that your mind just goes and goes and goes and goes and goes, we're allowing the mind to do this instead of us saying, God, come in. I need you. Save me. Hear my prayer, Lord. Hear me, God. And you won't have time for this. Because I used to have times for thinking too much. I said, why am I thinking about something that I can't control unless... until I thank God and I trust God and what he's going to do in my life. And I'm going to close up with this. I was doing the, and I shared it with the sisters earlier this morning. I was doing the radio, and that morning I had to go do my taxes. And I actually called the lady, and I was like, hey, you know, I want to go do my taxes earlier because my mom stayed with the baby. She had to go do another errand. And my timing is from 10 to 11 in the morning. And I called her. She was like, well, no, because you did your appointment at 12. I'm like, well, I wanted to see if I could, you know, come in earlier. And she was like, no, I'm sorry. And I was like, okay. So I told my mom, I was like, you know what? I'm just going to do radio. Might as well that I'm here. So I started doing radio. I started announcing about the toys. Hey, we're going to be doing the toys. If you guys want to donate, help, whatever. We need volunteers. We need everything. Anyone that wants to come and help, come on board. Literally 5 minutes within that, some lady calls me. And she's saying that she lives in Victorville. She's like, oh, I live in Victorville. And, you know, I was coming to, you know, visit my sister. And I hear this is a radio station, right? And I'm like, yeah, this is a radio station. She's like, well, you know, what is it about? And I was, you know, telling her about the radio station. And she was like, you know what? I want to donate 15 toys. And I'm like, whoa. Like, I was just asking for one toy. But, hey, if the Lord puts it in your heart. She's saying that she had a lot of Christmas toys. She had toys from Christmas that they were just there. And, you know, Christmas was almost now 2 months ago. That's what we have to do. And say, you know what? If I can, hey, if someone needs help, oh, here's $5. But if I know I can give 10, if I know I can do more or give her 5 and say, hey, do you need more help or what can I do? We could do it. We could extend the hand, right? And I was like, oh, you're sure? She was like, yeah, you know. So I'm going to meet up with her today and, you know, get the toys. And I'm like, thank you, God. But that's the God I serve. That's the God I serve, that he will supply all the needs. And these children, to see their faces, it's going to be unbelievable. So if you guys could come, join us. We need, like I said, we need the volunteers. We need those that want to come. If you guys could, let's go. Let's do this mission work. Let's see the happiness of these children. We're going to be doing hot dogs. We're going to be doing games. And we need those help. We need the volunteers. We're leaving next week. We've been announcing it for almost 2 months. So if you guys could, let's extend, let's help. And if you're saying, I can't go, you know, I just pay my bill or whatever the case may be, keep us in prayer. At least come up to me and be like, hey, I can't do A, B, C, D, E, F, G, but we're going to pray for you. I'm going to give my time that Saturday. I'm going to wake up early and I'm going to fast for that. That's all we want, is to get that extra time. Because remember, the Lord says it's better to give, to be a blessing to other to someone else and to receive it. Amen? So remember, if someone needs help, extend the hand. Don't do favors for favors. Don't do that. I'm going to do this and you don't do that. Come on. We're worth more than that. Amen? And we could do better than that. Father God, I want to thank you, Lord, for this time that you allow us to be in your word, Father. Thank you, Father God, because everything you do, Father, it's for your glory. In Jesus' name we pray and we say, Amen. I want to thank those that were watching us on our online. God bless you guys. Okay. Just because we're recording, I don't want